Auburn Blitz is now on the air. Your daily look into what's happening in Auburn athletics. With your host, Andy Graham, Brett Pritchard, Randy Lee, War Eagle.
Hello, everybody, and welcome into the Auburn Blitz here on this Wednesday. Brett and JJ here with you for your lunch hour. We're glad that you've joined us out there, wherever it is that you might be tuning us in. And our program brought to you by Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores, J.A. Smith Construction and Excavation, and Central Alabama Community College every single day. And we appreciate them so much. JJ, a lot to dive into, as always. In this ever-changing minute-by-minute world, you better hold on to your britches. Something will change on you in 5 minutes. Auburn with another guy in football going into portal. I know this is an Auburn show, but it's hard not to say, stuff about Alabama when it happens to them. You and I talking about that. Nick Pringle gets in the portal on basketball. That's four guys now for Alabama that have, a couple of guys off the bench, but
a couple of surprises, at least to me. Ryland Griffin, why? Yeah. What system are you going to find in you fit better than that one?
He's going to Kansas, it looks like.
They were, I think, near the bottom of Division I in three-point shooting, so maybe they made him a heck of an offer just to improve their three-point shooting.
Right, I don't,
the Walters kid, that surprised me a little bit.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, he's a developmental prospect. Pringle, to me, no surprise. He was in the doghouse half a year.
Right.
Suspended for, a couple of weeks.
He's a loose cannon. He's a loose cannon.
He didn't surprise me. But the transfer portal, here's the thing. We're gonna talk about all the kids going to the transfer portal everywhere.
Right.
And where they're going and why they're going. But today, NCAA is having a meeting where they are discussing a new rule that would allow unlimited transfers for any student athlete.
So let's make it worse.
Unlimited transfers, any student athlete, and as long as you're academically eligible, nobody sits.
Well, so let's make it worse. they've already got – do they do anything right?
Can
they get anything right?
Somehow they looked at the current situation and said, you know what we need?
We need screwed up worse.
We need more
chaos.
Of this.
I just have no words. I mean, literally the last 3 days on this program and on Sportz Blitz last night, me and Luke spent the entire first hour talking about the portal. Because as soon as it opens, as soon as they have opportunity, and I'll use Alabama as an example. They went to the Final Four this year, man.
Yeah.
Isn't that the goal?
And only one player had exhausted his eligibility. Aaron Estrada.
Right.
So
five guys now have left Alabama's team. One couldn't help it.
Estrada, Walters, Griffin, Pringle now.
And I don't know who the other kid was. He got very limited minutes.
Yeah. I don't know. My thought on Alabama was, if I'm Alabama, I want to hold on to two guys primarily.
Sears
and
Reitzel. You talking about Taylor Nelson?
Nelson. Right? And you'd love to hold on to Reitzel, right? Saw today where they're in on the Rutgers big man who's looking to transfer, and
right.
He may be the replacement for Pringle. Who knows? But in some ways, I can see where coaches go. I've got a chance to maybe. I can get a bad egg off my roster.
Oh, for sure.
And replace him with a good egg. You know what I mean? But at the same time, it just gets so. But like you said, you got a team that went to the Final Four. Only one person. Normally, that team would come into next season as a preseason number one.
No doubt.
And a favorite to win it all with everybody back.
The case anymore.
That's not college basketball today.
It's not college football either.
No.
I mean, it really isn't. I mean, you look at it from a standpoint of, crap. I mean, you've done everything. You're part of a great program. You've done what you needed to do, and you hightail it out. So, I feel like Groundhog Day. I really do. It's the culture we've created.
That's right.
We're victims of our own doing, and allowing, and again, the NCAA coming back, like you said today, looking like they're gonna screw it up even worse than it is now. You're going away from control. You're going further away from trying to have some parameters and things that people can abide by. Man, I mean, it's just turn it all loose now.
Yeah.
Let it just be the highest bidder. You can leave and you can go as many places as you want to go. If you have a bad day at practice, you can get pissed and you just pack your stuff and go somewhere else.
Yeah.
I mean, I hate it. Nobody's feeling sorry for a bunch of coaches that make multi-millions of dollars, but at the end of the day, though, man, to run a program that we all want to have success, they've got to be able to enforce some things.
Yeah.
I mean, Nick Saban, and we can say it two different ways. Look, Nick Saban, I think, got out because he couldn't do things the way he's always done them. You know, and then number two, you've got everybody being able to do maybe some things that he's always been able to do. Now everybody's been able to do it. And I think he just, at his age, doesn't want to fight with this crap anymore.
Yeah, yeah.
And Luke said it last night on the show. I mean, you're going to continue to lose some of your better college coaches.
Yeah.
Especially if they're toward the upper end of their career and they only have a few more years and they're contemplating whether they want to deal with this anymore.
Well, because if I go to the NFL, I've got to deal with free agency. I've got to deal with a salary cap. But it's got structure to it, right?
Exactly.
It's got rules to the game. And everybody knows what they are. If you don't abide by them, there's punishment. There are rules to the game. In college football right now, there literally are – college sports. There literally are no rules. And you know, the rule is whatever. You know, that's
– the NCAA has lost, if it had any power, the courts have pretty much rendered them useless. Now, is this an attempt for them to come back and try to gain some like from the student athletes?
Look, I don't know. I think there's so much. Look, the courts basically enforced capitalism in the NIL decisions, right? But as far as the transfer portal thing, this is an NCAA thing.
Oh, of course it is.
You can enforce the sitting out a year if everybody agrees, right? You can enforce that. And it's one of the reasons, a good example of why leadership matters, right? Say what you want about Roger Goodell, and people have said good things and bad things,
right?
But the NFL is the most popular sports brand in the world.
And most powerful.
Because they try to handle their problems. And a good example, go back to when Jamarcus Russell was drafted first overall by the Raiders.
Right.
It set that franchise back 10 years. Because in those days, there was no rookie salary cap. You paid whatever. So if you drafted a quarterback number one, man, you're throwing $100 million in there. Your salary cap is busted for the next 5, 6, 7 years.
Absolutely.
Right?
So
if you miss, you're toast. Well, the NFL said, well, maybe we shouldn't make it so punitive if you make a bad. So we'll have a rookie salary cap, right? So now I've basically got 4 years with a fifth-year option. If I draft a quarterback high, yes, I'm paying them well, but I'm not paying them.
Yeah, I'm not breaking.
Not paying $110 million.
Exactly.
I'm not broken for the next 6 or 7 years because I missed on a guy at the top of the draft. And so the NFL fixed that problem. And so now you see situations where the Miami Dolphins trying to figure out how they're going to handle the Tua thing. Team after team, New York Giants and Danny Dimes. You know, how do we handle this? He's not the quarterback maybe that we envisioned. Do we want to keep him? If so, what do we pay him? But the NFL fixed that problem. College football, NCAA looks at the transfer portal issues and goes, need a little more of that. Yeah, a little more of this. This is going to help us.
Really, what do you think the rationale is behind them wanting to expand unlimited transfer?
I have no clue.
Is there any coach out there you feel like is in favor of this?
Yeah, no. No. I can't imagine there's a single one. Lane Kiffin, just because he's crazy? I don't know.
Again, you're going to benefit by getting players, but man, you're losing It's just a complete and total revolving door at your complex all the time.
Yeah.
You don't know who you're going to have. I mean, look, I had stories of Terry Bowden at Auburn. He didn't remember some guys' names.
Right.
Okay. There's a story. He walked up behind a player in a restaurant, and he said, dang, you know, big man, you know, we need to get you out of football. He said, coach, I'm on the team. I'm number so-and-so. You know, and I get that every once in a while, you know, walk on, whatever. But now I can really see where you could – be like, is he on our roster still? Is he still here, or did he leave?
Yeah.
You know, do we have him? Because, I mean, there's a couple different, you know, the cross-conference, we talked about this yesterday. You can't transfer to another team in the SEC in the second portal window. So now in this portal window, if you wanted to transfer, you got to go somewhere out of conference.
Yeah.
But in the first portal window that closes on February 1, before February 1, you could transfer. That's how Auburn got the left tackle.
Yeah.
You know, Percy Lewis from Mississippi State. You know, he was able to leave and come over. But now if he were getting in the portal, he couldn't. If he wanted to transfer, he'd have to go somewhere else, you know, outside of the conference.
You mentioned Nick Saban. How many times did we talk about Saban's rule, what they used to call processing, right? But Saban always had the same rule with every kid. You come in, you're going to develop. Hopefully by your second year, you're contributing, whether it's special teams or whatever.
Right.
By your third year, if you're not a contributor in the rotation, then I endorse you transferring.
Sure.
Right? I'm okay with you. If you hadn't made it by your third year, probably not going to.
Right.
So if you're not a contributor by then, yeah, let's get you somewhere where you can play.
Right.
That seems perfectly fair to
no
me.
No doubt.
But is there a kid in college football now that wants to take 3 years to develop?
Not at all. Not that. Absolutely not even close. Not even on the table.
Yeah.
So, man, I get exhausted talking about this. It seems like this is what we talk about every single day, but it's what you have to. I mean, it's your rosters are constantly changing and moving every single minute, it seems like. Up against another break. Stay tuned. More to come right here on the Auburn Blitz.
Hi, this is Brian Bice with Bice Motors. With our all-star lineup of Dodge trucks, Jeep, SUVs, and Chrysler cars, we offer the area a team dedicated to making your next vehicle purchase a positive experience. Our sales team offers competitive pricing, and we back up all sales with service department second to none. Bice Motors also offers the area's best selection of pre-owned vehicles. Visit Bice Motors at 2133 Cherokee Road in Alexander City.
Heritage South Credit Union in Alexander City is your community credit union, and they have been for over 80 years. Heritage South Credit Union proudly serves Tallapoosa, Coosa, Lee, Chambers, Randolph, and Chilton counties. From checking to business accounts, to share savings to club accounts, to their kids club and investments, visit them online at myhscu.com. Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union for 80 years, federally insured by NCUA.
When you need an automotive hero, you got to call S&S Discount Tire Pros. With locations in Alexander City and Daville, we are here to serve you today. From quick services like oil changes and tire rotations to in-depth automotive repairs such as suspensions, brakes, and tune-ups, S&S can take care of all your tire needs. You just have to focus on what's important and love the drive. Call S&S Discount Tire Pros today. We are automotive heroes, and we are here to serve you.
WOTM is the television provider for all Alabama High School Athletic Association championship events and special programs. WOTM is your home for the Super 7 football, state finals basketball, baseball and softball state championships, the AHSAA weekly show, and WOTM also produced the first ever football playoff show, Super 7 preview show, and reclassification reveal show. Your exclusive home for all things AHSAA is WOTM. Contact your local cable provider to request WOTM to your channel lineup.
Whether it's Lake Martin, Lay Lake, or Logan Martin, boaters from all over the state of Alabama come to Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama, because it's worth the drive. With the best deals on unbeatable Suzuki outboards, Manitou and Landau tritunes, and a great pre-owned inventory while they last, Alex City Marine is the pros the locals know. And no matter where you're from, when you're here, you're local to us. Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama. AlexCityMarine.com.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
Let's get serious. Let's get Arctic Air serious. You want your car and truck to live longer, don't you? Well, it's about maintenance. Same thing with Arctic Air. You see the number at the bottom of the screen? Call them right now. Let me tell you something. You want to be comfortable? We all want to be comfortable.
Truckloads of fresh inventory are rolling in to Glenn Smith GMC in Opelika, like this powerful all-new GMC Sierra 1500 SLT. Now available with up to $13,000 off. Purchase the roomy GMC Terrain SLT, discounted up to $97.50 off. And the GMC Acadia AT4 all-wheel drive, discounted up to $8,000 off. Enjoy no payments till the end of summer at Glenn Smith GMC. Over 350 new and used vehicles on the lot or on the way.
Get ready to smile.
You know what I think? I think you just need to just scrap the whole daggum thing and start over.
Start over.
That's
kind of what the Big Ten and the SEC are talking about with this new underleagues and super leagues. And I don't know if you read that proposal.
Well, I mean, I had a buddy send this to me during the break, and I saw this a couple of days ago. So I might as well talk about it. Basically, you can go on to Fan Cave. And this is online, and you can pretty much pledge money through NIL and entice players to basically come to your school. And they can weigh all the different things, and, you know, they've got a disclaimer on here talking about it's perfectly legal and it's NCAA compliant. Well, what isn't NCAA compliant now, right? Outside of going to jail. I mean, how do you even manage? Look, I'm trying to just wrap my head around all this stuff that a coach is trying to deal with, you know, dealing with fan pressure, you know, to put a good product on the field. But, man, you're managing this crap.
Think about the stuff that now it's another level of evaluation too, right? Because,
right,
you know, you're going to evaluate the physical skill, right?
Right.
You want to evaluate a kid's competitive nature. That's why I always thought a kid that took his senior year off in high school, if I were a coach, I'm not interested. I'm a pass there.
Right.
You know, now you've got to evaluate, is this a kid that wants to come here because, you know, thinks his brand is going to blow up and blah, 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 blah.
Right.
Or is this a kid that wants to come here and win football games? I got to try to evaluate that in there. Is he going to be looking to leave the first opportunity? Where's his motivation?
Right.
You got to weigh all that now as another level as you're evaluating kids that you might or might not want to bring into your program.
Caden Proctor transferred to Iowa, and then he transferred back to
somebody. I saw a funny one. Somebody said he just transferred over there because he wanted to watch Caitlin Clark play. Yeah.
Well, I tell you why he did transfer over there, to go get $100,000, because apparently Iowa paid him $100,000 to leave Alabama and come to Iowa. Well, he did. He didn't tell him how long he was going to stay.
Just $100,000?
Just $100.
I mean, we got the Georgia quarterback driving a Lamborghini.
But here's a guy, but here's a guy that left the school where apparently he knew the whole time he wasn't planning to go up there to Iowa and stay. He goes and collects some money and then comes back. We had a call last night on the show. They said, did he have to give that money back? And it's like Luke said, no, you don't have to give any of that.
Why would you have to give it back?
So literally he just drove back home for a few months, got $100,000, and came on back down to Alabama. I mean, yeah, it's a great gig if you can get it, but, I mean, what are we teaching people, man?
Well, I mean,
I don't know, man.
Again, we were talking about this when you mentioned the thing where you can go on and bid on players, right?
That's yourself. What you're doing.
Fan cave. Go check it out. Yeah. Number one, one name you will never see on there in your life.
You?
Is me. Because
you don't care how good they are.
There ain't an 18-year-old kid in this world that's going to get a dime out of me to go to any college anywhere, other than my own, right? I can see it now. Hey, everybody, make sure you go contribute $5 or $10. No. What are you doing? It's the dumbest thing I ever heard of.
Well, I won't, you know, this was brought up yesterday, and I hate to continue to repeat things, but I think it warrants, and it has a little merit to it. You know, JJ, a lot of these people that are donating money to the collectives and to the NIL went to college there, actually got a degree from there, went and started a business, went and worked for somebody, sure. Did something. You know, so they're giving money back to help the school, help the athletic program.
I totally get that.
Now you got a bunch of dadgum people, kids coming out with their hands stuck out wanting millions of dollars right now. They ain't done a thing.
Yeah.
They ain't earned squat, man. And we're all giddy. And when I say we, you know, the public out here to get whatever kid to get to come to our school, we'll pay them whatever. And then, they may not like it there in 9 months, so they may pack all their stuff up and leave. But by the way, they're going to take all the money that you gave them with them.
That's right.
This sport's dead, dude. I mean, I hate to say it.
You know, I was listening to somebody yesterday, and I don't remember who it was. But they made an excellent point. Might have been Creslow. And they said, all of this is so, and we complained about it in the off season, and we hate it. We want it done differently. We want a structure in there. We know it's got to be fixed. Said, but when it's 3rd and 8 from your opponent's 20 and you're down by 4 with 3 minutes left, none of that matters, right? When the game's going on, you're still in it, right?
You are.
And that is what, so far, is keeping college football going, because there are a lot of fans. I think if you took the fact that the games are so much daggum fun out of the situation, not worth it anymore, right?
Well, I brought this up last night. I think that we're getting to that point. I've talked to many people that this has just killed their interest and their fire for college athletics. You know, and I'm talking about diehard people that you would have thought 10 years ago would have never said some of the things they're saying. And they're just like, you know what, man? Let these kids go and beg and let these colleges pay these kids whatever they want to and sell their soul to them and let them get hung out to dry and let them transfer and let them keep taking all this money. I'm not going to be privy to it, nor am I going to care anymore on Saturdays.
Right.
You know, the Auburn-Tennessee game or the Alabama-Florida game or whatever just don't mean anything anymore.
But you know where the proof in that is, though? It's going to be in the ratings, and the ratings keep going up.
It's the product out there for people to watch.
Yeah, so here's the thing. The only way that college football goes, hey, wait a minute, we got to step back and take a look at this, is if ratings start dropping.
Well, of course. Well,
attendance
yeah.
starts dropping. But right now, I mean, good gosh, when you can go to any SEC stadium outside of Nashville on a Saturday and be in a packed-out house with a waiting list to get on season tickets or watch a game on television and break records every time you turn around.
Right.
It's just, you know, that's
but
where.
But I don't think until this point you really started to see exhaustion with it like you're starting to see now. I mean, it'll be interesting.
I mean, we'll find out.
Yeah, we'll find out. You know, attendance in some of these places were already going south.
Sure.
You know, people not spending the money and doing that, and you know, they're begging for more money, coaches and collectives and all, and you got less people, you know, in some of these areas, not all of them, that are deciding. You know what? I'm maxed out, bro. I'm not doing that anymore. Mm. So y'all go figure it out. So up against another break here on the Auburn Blitz. Stay tuned. More to come right after this.
This is Kathy Holmes with Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine. Jeff Verner and I opened in East Montgomery 25 years ago and have become the premier butcher shop, wine retailer, and caterer in the River Region. We are excited to invite you to our newest location at 2459 East Glen Avenue in Auburn, Opelika. We want to become your one-stop shop for the freshest cuts of meat in town, grab-and-go casseroles, gift items, and the best wine selection in the area. Think of us when catering your next event. Check us out online at steaksandwine.com for daily lunch specials and details on upcoming wine tastings and fun events.
Late Mark Garage, located on Highway 280 in Jackson's Gap, has been serving our area since 1993. From routine maintenance such as oil changes, tune-ups, and rotating and balancing your tires, transmission and engine repair, our trained and certified mechanics will get you back on the road better than before. Need a tow? With a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week towing service, Late Mark Garage has local and long-range pickup. Trust your vehicle needs to the professionals at Late Mark Garage. Call 256-825-6139, or better yet, stop in and see them today. Late Mark Garage.
What's the verdict?
Can't fix your heat pump. Need a new one.
Uh-oh. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking Daikin.
Call on Kevin Kill and Sunshine Heating and Air at 256-825-4849, Central Alabama's premier Daikin dealer.
So what's he thinking?
Oh, he's thinking Daikin.
Daikin, one of the top selling in the world.
Now I'm thinking Daikin.
Daikin, comfort for life.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
There is only one option for top-of-the-line aftermarket upgrades on your vehicle, and that's Frontline Outfitters. We offer quality parts, lift kits, custom wheels and tires, bed covers, step bars, and toolboxes. They're installed by trained and skilled professionals, to custom powder coating with hundreds of colors and finishes, to the highest quality film for window tinting using state-of-the-art film cutting technology. Call Frontline Outfitters at 256-409-8100. Don't be in the back of the line. Put your vehicle at the front with Frontline Outfitters. Grain and Leaf, located at 6068 Highway 63 South, is Lake Martin's premier boutique-style bottle shop with a unique array of sophistication for everyone. Appropriately named for its exclusive selection of top spirits, wine, and craft beer, Grain and Leaf also has a number of fine cigars for you to choose from. They also carry the full line of Hornsby Farms assorted jellies and pottery. Open 10 to 7 Monday through Saturday and noon to 5 on Sundays, Grain and Leaf is your premier shop in the Lake Martin area.
Lake Martin Mobile Detailing is the number one auto and boat detailing company in Central Alabama. Don't trust your boat or vehicle to just anybody. Hire the professionals. Top-of-the-line ceramic coating, detailing, gel coat restoration, and paint correction gives you the options to take care of your vehicle the right way. Located at 702 McCarty Road in Dable, Lake Martin Mobile Detailing will have you riding in style. Call them today at 256-794-2328 for Superior Automotive and Boat Detailing.
J.A. Smith Construction is your trusted choice for construction site clearing and grading for new home construction, underground utilities and site work, concrete paving, storm drain installation, fish ponds, and slough dredging. No job is too big or too small. Call Alexander at J.A. Smith Construction at 256-896-1400 or email asmith@jasmithconstruct.com. J.A. Smith Construction, your trusted choice for construction.
Registration for the 41st Alabama State Games is now open at alagames.com. Join us as we return to Birmingham for an exciting 3 days of Olympic-styled action June 7th through 9th. There are 24 sports offered and $40,000 in scholarships up for grabs. The Alabama State Games brings a mix of individual and team sports for all ages and abilities, so everyone can go for the gold. Don't let this opportunity pass you by. Registration and event info can be found at alagames.com.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz halfway through the program here in segment three. It means it's time for the Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine daily lunch special. And I mean, JJ's got this thing.
Salmon and cracked chicken.
That's it. Salmon and cracked chicken.
I'm assuming that's a choice. You don't get both.
No, right? You don't get
both. You can order both if you want.
Oh, yeah. Sure you can. They're not gonna stop you for sure. So you get your choice of one of those with two sides. So roasted sweet potato, sauteed spinach, twice-baked potato, wild rice, baked beans, potato salad, veggie medley, sauteed asparagus, steamed broccoli, sauteed green beans, homemade mac and cheese.
Yeah, yum. I haven't eaten yet, so.
Yes, all the above.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. I'll have one.
Exactly. I'll have one of each. All right. So on the 26th, we'll have some food up here on display for
next Friday, right?
That's exactly right. That is next Friday.
We're gonna display our eating.
Well, we're gonna do that prior.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna do that prior, and then we'll have
nobody wants to see that.
Yeah, we're gonna have to make sure we hold off some of that off to the side so we got something to showcase, because around here it'll be like like buzzards on the side of the road, right? But anyway, thanks to Kathy and everybody at Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine, man. Just great, great partners here on the program. Ty said, I wish the NCAA would come up with a rule: if you transfer, you got to pay the school back for the scholarship they spend on you. I mean, in essence, we talked about this yesterday. It's going to have to come down to some type of contract. The schools really need to be the one to control the money.
Yep.
And it's going to be a contractual thing. And then –
collectives can control it, whoever.
Yeah, whatever you handle. We actually even talked about doing away with the collective, getting that out of there and letting the school actually handle all the funds to try to control what goes on.
It would be the kind of thing where, you know, we have an NIL standard in place, right? And here it is. But it comes to you incrementally. You paid,
right?
You know, in the NFL they get game checks, right? So is it a game check? Is it a monthly check? To me, I would break it up monthly, you know. And then, you know, if you want to leave, that's fine. I'm just sacrificing all of it going forward.
So you know, again, I hear what Ty's saying. I think there needs to be. It should not be, hey, give me all this, and I don't have to follow through with my end of the bargain.
Right.
I mean, there's a lot.
There is no end of the bargain for the player right now.
That's right.
End of the bargain.
We went from a pendulum swing all the way from one side to the other. We were like, okay, the players have no rights, and all the coaches and the schools have all the control, to now the players have all the control.
Yeah.
And really the schools have no – but, again, it goes hand in hand. What are these kids going to play? What facility are they going to go practice in? If there's not a school, who are they going to play for? So the schools actually do have some leverage.
Yeah.
But are they going to enforce it? Well, the problem is every school's not going to do it. There's going to be some out there, come on over here. We'll give you everything you want.
That's right.
And instead of everybody locking arms saying, look, the only way we stop this is that we're all a unified front.
The first thing I believe, well, I know we've talked about, I feel like I beat this horse so much. But
I feel like that's all we've talked about for the 4 days.
The first thing that they really need to happen, college athletics, governing body, whether that's the NCAA or whether it's this new thing, the SEC and the Big Ten have floated out there, or whatever it is, needs antitrust exemption from the United States Congress.
Right.
That's got to happen, or courts are just going to overturn whatever restrictions you put. Because without an antitrust exemption, then you're denying someone the opportunity to maximize their income potential, that's illegal.
That's it. That's
you can't just do it because you want to. I can't come in here and go, hey, by the way, salesperson A, if you break $10,000 a month in commission,
you got to stop.
You don't get any more after that.
That's right.
You know,
I
can't do that.
That's right.
You know, so it's, you know, there's got to be. That's why we have antitrust laws. That's why they exist. So, you know, if Congress can pay attention for, you know, more than 30 seconds to something, maybe we'd get that done.
Yeah, I did. Again. The NCAA and Congress, boy, let's place your hopes.
We got the right people in charge now, don't we?
Let's place your hopes on those two great bodies of work for sure. So now we all understand why it's a mess.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now we know why society's a mess, and we know why college athletics are a mess. So real quick before we go to this next break, Aiden Holloway in the transfer portal for Auburn. on basketball. It looks like he's going to visit Alabama tomorrow.
Really?
So Aiden Holloway heading to possibly Tuscaloosa next year.
I got news for him. If Mark Sears comes back, he ain't running point.
Well, I think it kind of sends a message, and I know that Alabama probably is looking for another guard too, but I don't think Mark Sears is coming back. Mm-hmm. I mean, it just feels like he's going to go try his luck at the pros. And, you know, again,
you can't ask any more out of what you got.
He rode that year to a Final Four. You don't know what next year is going to bring.
Yeah.
You know, you may not even make the tournament next year. I mean, I'm not saying Alabama won, but you just don't know, man.
Yeah.
And so, and he may not have the year that he had this year, and his stock's high. So he's like, maybe this is the highest my stock's ever going to get. Right. If I came back and had a similar year, it's not going to change anything. Sure. So why not go ahead and go now?
Yeah, I'm not going to go from averaging 23 to averaging 30. You know.
Exactly. Yeah. So, I mean, I may go down to 18.
Yeah.
You know, and everybody's like, well, what happened? That must have been a flash in the pan. So, I mean, I think he and Grant Nelson both end up trying their luck at the next one. We'll see, though. Up against another break. Stay tuned. More to come right after this.
of nurses say they went into the profession because they wanted to help patients. No matter the reason you decided to become a nurse, you have all the tools needed to advance your degree at Jacksonville State University. Our Master's in Nursing program is now offered fully online and can be completed in less than 2 years. You can customize a flexible course schedule so you can receive your advanced education degree all while working on the front lines. JSU Nursing, your opportunity to advance your career and serve your community.
At CNT Electric, our clients are our priority. For the safety and security of your family and home, our technicians are professionally trained, drug tested, background checked, and wear uniforms with name tags. We're proud to have served the Elk City, Dadeville, and Lake Martin areas for the past 10 years. Give us a call at 256-234-0007 for all your electrical service and repair needs. Or visit us on the web at www.cntelectricllc.com and spell out the word AND.
Zaxby's has been perfecting chicken fingers for 30 years, and now we're going to the sea. Shrimp butterflied and fried to perfection in a perfect blend of Zax sauce and cocktail sauce called Zaxtail sauce. The perfect southern fried shrimp meal. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's. Zaxby's has been perfecting chicken fingers for 30 years, and now we're going to the sea. Shrimp butterflied and fried to perfection in a perfect blend of Zax sauce and cocktail sauce called Zaxtail sauce. The perfect southern fried shrimp meal. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
WOTM is the television provider for all Alabama High School Athletic Association championship events and special programs. WOTM is your home for the Super 7 football, state finals basketball, baseball and softball state championships, the AHSAA weekly show, and WOTM also produced the first ever football playoff show, Super 7 preview show, and reclassification reveal show. Your exclusive home for all things AHSAA is WOTM. Contact your local cable provider to request WOTM to your channel lineup.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
Bucks Island is your boating headquarters. Are you ready to hit the water and go boating this summer? Bucks Island has all kinds of boats, with one sure to fit exactly what you want. Fishing boats, sport boats, pontoon boats, and all with low monthly payments. Call 1-800-I'M-READY. Bucks Island Service Department experts are also here for you to keep your boat in top running condition. Call 1-800-I'M-READY. Don't be left standing on the bank this summer. Visit online at bucksisland.com. And don't buy a boat till you get a Bucks quote.
Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation is coming soon to the corner of 280 and 49 North in Dadeville. This new 10,000 square foot facility is conveniently located to serve the residents of the Lake Martin area and its many communities. A branch of Frederick Dean Funeral Home and Crematory in Opelika, Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation looks forward to serving your families and your communities, as we have since 1900 at Frederick Dean. 256-750-0381.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz. Couple segments left on today's show, brought to you by Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores. With 9 locations in Central Alabama for all your home building supply needs, they have what you need, so make sure you go check out one of their 9 locations. J.A. Smith Construction and Excavation, they have everything you need. They can handle the small jobs all the way to the big, huge commercial projects. So make sure you give J.A. Smith Construction a call today for your next lot clearing, whatever it is that you got to have done, make sure you call on them. And Central Alabama Community College, with 4 locations in Central Alabama for your 2-year degree needs or your transfer needs, your education transfer needs, they've got what you need there. Talking about Kentucky and Arkansas, with Calipari leaving, when Calipari showed up to Arkansas, he didn't have a team. He said, I went and met with the team. There was no team.
Yeah.
So he said, y'all think that's a little funny, but he said, it's a little scary.
Yeah.
He said, I got a lot of work to do to put a roster together, but we're going to put one together. Now Kentucky's down to 2 players from last year's team. This is just unbelievable, man. I mean, he just complete and total depletion.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, all right, everybody clean their locker out. It's like the last day of school. You know, you make sure you got all your belongings and everything cleaned out, because what's left in your locker is going to get thrown out.
Yeah.
And we starting over again. I mean, everybody's got to start over.
And I think in basketball, it hurts so much worse than football because of numbers.
Right.
You know, you're only talking 13 players. So it doesn't take – you don't have to lose a lot to be replacing just about everybody.
Exactly.
And I think – as a fan, it hurts a little worse than basketball, too, because basketball is what you see these kids, right? I mean, you know, they're not covered up in helmets and, you know, uniforms, and there's not, you know, 85 of them. There's 13, and you know, over the course of time, you kind of feel like you get to know them a little bit.
That's right.
At this point, you know, if I get you for half a season, can you transfer in at Christmas? And, you know,
you know, Jalen Williams, that's why he's an anomaly. This past year, Auburn stayed four-plus years, and the winning is basketball player. Janai Broome, if he comes back, my gosh, you know, he transferred from Morehead State, and who would have thought Auburn would be able to have him for 3 possible years? You know, I think Bruce Pearl's done a really good job of holding on to his players. You know, Baker Mazar is back, Dylan Cardwell's back, Denver Jones is back, Chaney Johnson's back. Janai Broome, if he comes back, is huge. You did lose Aiden Holloway and Katie Johnson and Trey Donaldson, but, you know, you got 2 really good players coming in, and then you just got Pegues from Furman to kind of take one of their places. I mean, Todd Pettiford's coming in as a true freshman. He'll pretty much take Aiden Holloway's place. I mean, keeping guys is probably the biggest win that you can have in this modern era of college sports. And, you know, not having to go out there like, you know, again, Nate Oates is already down 5 players. You know, last year he lost, what, 7 or 8?
Yeah.
I mean,
he lost 7 of his top 9 in the rotation.
I mean, good Lord.
Yeah.
And then he comes back and goes to the Final 4, which is, you know, kudos to him.
Yeah.
You know, but it ain't always going to work out like that. You keep having to replace 7, 8, 9 guys every year.
Yeah,
you're going to miss on some. And some of them aren't going to be as productive as you would hope they would be. And but, again, what else do you do? I mean, if they leave, you got to go get somebody to replace them.
Got
to
do it. Yeah. So, and, you know, there's such an interesting thing, too, because there's, all, you know, there's, you know, former 5-star here, former 5-star there. Or do you look for one of those Aaron Estrada types, a guy who's 23 years old.
Oh, by the way, had gone to his 4th school.
Has 1 year of eligibility left, but he's been around. He's been in big games. He's been in tournaments. How do you fill that roster? It's just as important.
No doubt. Because
if you go out and take somebody's friend, like, you know, oh, this guy decommitted from Kentucky, so now he's going to sign with us. Do I get him for a year? I mean.
Well, and in NCAA, according to what you said to start the show, it's going to make his problem even worse.
I mean, that's the new rule they're contemplating, is unlimited transfers as long as you're academically eligible.
So let me ask you, can conferences put a restriction on that?
We always did. In football, the SEC always had one. You know,
well, it is right now.
I mean, inside the conference, you sit a year.
Outside of the second portal.
But yep. I don't think they can restrict how many times. I mean, maybe within the conference they can, but there's, you know, there's 120 other schools.
I mean, it's almost like federal laws versus state laws.
Yeah.
You know, when does one take over the other, or when does one apply? So, again, I guess the SEC could say, look, okay, you can do that, not here, you're not.
Right.
You know, we got our own set of rules. You can transfer wherever you want to go, but you ain't going to do it here in this conference.
Yeah.
You're not going to be at five different SEC schools in 5 years.
Right.
I mean, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, and I think all the coaches would vote against that as well. I mean, Luke and I talked about it last night. I think the not being able to transfer inside your conference during the second portal window is huge, because that means you've been through a spring.
Yeah.
You know, and you've
got information.
You've got a lot of information, yeah. You know. I think that's something that ought to be.
There's a little extra NIL. I'm going to need a – did you download a copy of that playbook?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, that's exactly and that's not naive, and that's not your head in the sand out of the realm of possibility. You know that's going on.
Oh, yeah.
So, just like, okay, well, I'm a coach. I can't talk to a kid. I can't coerce that kid to come to my school, but I can't stop my players from calling him.
That's right.
Hey, friends, right?
You know what? My next-door neighbor, he's one of them friendly guys. He reaches out to people all the time.
Hey, no doubt, man. He just wants to check in. He just wants to check in, see how everybody's doing, you know. Wild. Just NCAA, way to go. You know, we were cheering you on, man.
Your leadership is appreciated.
Hey, we haven't burned every ounce of the building down. We're going to try to get it all to complete ash before it's all said and done. But talking about the roster for Auburn, again, still waiting to hear about Janai Broome. I know a lot of you sending messages and asking, do we have any update? We don't. I mean, just no update yet. I think that's going to happen sooner than later. I think Janai Broome.
Do you think he would start by declaring but leaving open the option to come back?
No, I think he's just going to come back. I think he's going to get an evaluation, and I don't think he's going to be drafted that high. I don't think his projection's that high, and I think he'll come back and he'll be favorite for National Player of the Year and definitely SEC Player of the Year coming back in. And, again, he'll be able to maybe more into a four and put Dylan Cardwell on the floor as a five and let him work some more on that outside shot, which he got a lot better with this year,
right.
Which everybody thinks that at his size and his ability, he's going to have that.
Got to have a mid-range.
Going to have to have that to get in the NBA. So.
Yep.
All right, up against our final break of the show, one final segment coming up right after this.
When drinking, take a sober ride home, not someone's life. Alabama has a code of the road, and knowing it helps you follow it. This is a message from your Alabama Department of Transportation.
J.A. Smith Construction is your trusted choice for construction site clearing and grading for new home construction, underground utilities and site work, concrete paving, storm drain installation, fish ponds, and slough dredging. No job is too big or too small. Call Alexander at J.A. Smith Construction at 256-896-1400 or email asmith@jasmithconstruct.com. J.A. Smith Construction, your trusted choice for construction.
SignSource is your local vendor for commercial and residential sign manufacturing and installation. We offer all kinds of lighted and non-lighted signage, from retail signs, LED message centers, event banners, vehicle wraps, the whole spectrum. We also offer service and repair on existing signs, as well as retrofitting to LED or installation of outsourced signage. We have the knowledge necessary to fulfill all of your signage needs in the short or long term. Visit signsourcenow.com to get started.
EnviroCare is the standard in East Central Alabama for all your pest control and termite needs. EnviroCare exclusively offers Centricon Termite Colony Elimination System that is the industry's most effective termite control to protect your home year-round. The EnviroCare team's service is also the standard for our customers. From eliminating home pests to superior termite control, nobody cares like EnviroCare, serving Lake Martin and East Central Alabama.
Chick-fil-A is always the best option when you're on the go, but they are also great when it comes to planning your next event, from tailgating to birthday parties to weddings. Call Chick-fil-A Alexander City at 256-289-7955 for catering or order on the Chick-fil-A app. Make sure to choose the Alexander City location and have your catering order ready to go. Nugget trays, mac and cheese trays, fruit trays, cookie trays, gallons of our famous lemonade or tea, and chilled grilled chicken sub sandwiches, and a lot more options. Make it Chick-fil-A Alexander City for your next event.
Folks around these parts have known for a long time that Walls Tire, just a mile past the bridge on Highway 280, is your number one stop for automotive service and repair. At Walls Tire, you'll always find quality service at a fair price on everything from AC, name brand tires, big or small repairs, routine maintenance, towing, and more. When your car or truck needs to run right, there's one place in the area to go, conveniently located and easy to find. Walls Tire, just a mile past the bridge on Highway 280.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Catch a ride, not a buzz.
Hey, can you come get me?
Being buzzed still counts. Alabama has a code of the road, and knowing it helps you follow it. This is a message from your Alabama Department of Transportation.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz final segment here on the program, brought to you by Russell Dewitt Center and Building Supply Stores, J.A. Smith Construction and Excavation, and Central Alabama Community College. Auburn got a big win on the field last night against Georgia Tech. They needed it. Just a team that's been reeling in conference play, but a midweek game against a very good opponent, Georgia Tech. Auburn ends up winning that game 12-8. They got out to an 8-0 lead in the first inning. Mm. And then you blink and it was 8-7. And it's like, man, the pitching just has not.
It's just been one of those years where it hasn't lived up
right
to what you thought.
But
you
then know? After Joseph Gonzalez had another shaky outing, Herbert Holtz came in for a couple innings, and then coming down the stretch, Auburn shut them down. I think it took four guys total, but here, Coach Thompson, some quotes from him from last night. He said, it was great. He said, I've been waiting. He said, I didn't know what to do after the last out. It'd been a minute. Every time we take the field, you want to have success. For these guys, I know things will turn, and I know baseball will get back to normal. We got another filled-up crowd. We got guys that are still fighting and engaged, and I'm tickled to death to see that after we've been kicked and beat and beat and beat. And he said, really, the man, the woman, the team, the person, at the end of the day, if you can create some stamina and don't go away, it will shift back. So, just trying to stay the course and, this team to fight. I know Bruce Pearl went and talked to the team the other night, mm-hmm. Just trying to say, look, man, you can still go on a run. You can still turn this thing around. Look at the last 4 years. Majority of you guys are back, You just need some stuff. You need to start creating your own luck. And, Auburn's lost a lot of one-run and two-run games. And, you go back to that Arkansas series. They lost two one-run games to the number one team in the country. Lost a 1-0 game and a 5-4 game. Then you win the Sunday game 8-6. You're not that far off.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like that with the record. The record looks horrible. But, Auburn, the bats have been there. The fielding for the most part has been there, but that one element that's so key is pitching. I mean, Auburn goes out and scores nine runs, but to give up 11.
Yeah.
You ain't going to beat anybody. When you just cannot, and it's been up and down. And Auburn, I believe, returned 85% of their innings pitched from last year.
Wow.
So you felt pretty good coming into the season. So, again, like you said, it's just one of those deals. They got to go on the road to Mississippi State. They got at Mississippi State, at LSU, Ole Miss at home at Missouri, and then Alabama comes in for the final week of the season. And I think, you know, Alabama's right there on the cusp too. You know, they had a big series win against Arkansas that got them, you know, back in contention. But, you know, there's Auburn and Alabama again, and then again talking about something that beating a dead horse, always going to have the cards stacked against them a little bit in the state.
Yeah.
Just through the laws and what they can offer and the scholarship limitations and all that. So you got to almost be – Jason Caldwell said it last Friday. He said you almost have to be perfect every time you go on the field.
Yeah.
Yep. All right, so, JJ, let's shift over last 4 minutes here. Talk about the Atlanta Braves. I mean, it gives you an opportunity to kind of – you said it, me and you talked about it coming on the air. They're beat up. Albies goes on the DL, but they continue to win. And the Astros really don't want them to come back to Minute Maid Park.
You know, and the Astros are off to just a terrible start. I think they're 6-13.
They are.
I mean, that's just that's pathetic. It's the worst in their division. I don't expect the Astros to stay at the bottom of their division.
Right.
But, you know, as far as Atlanta goes, they're doing what they're doing with Ronald Acuna off to a slow start.
He hadn't hit a home run yet.
He hadn't hit a home run.
Now, he killed one last night that was foul.
Yeah. It's the old back of the baseball card, don't lie kind of thing.
It does.
You're not moving Ronald Acuna to the nine hole to let him work it out. He's staying right where he is. He'll be fine.
Well, his average is not bad. I mean, He's still hitting, still putting the ball in play.
I noticed he changed from the yellow protective gear to black protective gear. I wonder if that was a superstition thing, right?
Well, I mean, the yellow one worked pretty doggone good last year.
It did.
He had an MVP year off of it.
Well, I think as long as the Braves can keep winning games, they're what, two games up, two and a half, three?
Yeah, I'm looking at the standings right now. They're two games over Philly right
two
now.
Two games up. As long as you stay in that, then you get to the All-Star break. You can make a move. They're going to have to make a move on a pitcher.
They had a bad series against the Mets.
Yeah.
I mean, you're not going to win them all, but Atlanta's 11-5, Philly's 10-8, New York's 9-8, Washington 7-10, and Miami's just horrible.
Yeah.
4-14, and
so if I'm the Braves, I'm going to keep rocking. You know, throw a young pitcher in here, or there, bring a guy up, let him eat some innings, and then see if I can get to the All-Star break in first place, and you know, or right there at it, and see if you need to pick somebody up.
So, yeah, looking up the toughest division in baseball, man, is the American League East. New York's 12-6, Baltimore 11-6, Toronto's 10-8, Tampa Bay's 10-8, and Boston's 9-9. You talk about five.
By the way, Marcelo Zuna,
yeah,
is on fire.
And last year, you remember the start?
That guy can't stop hitting baseball.
How many games now? Last year's start, they were like, the dude can't get a hit.
Yeah.
Hey, just go up there without a bat and see if you can take a walk,
It shows you the nature of baseball, because baseball is not a sport for consistency.
I think that's what Coach Thompson's trying to tell Auburn's team.
Consistency is balancing your runs and your,
right.
You know.
I know it sucked to this point, but you got five series left.
Yeah.
And you could win all five of those series. Everybody else has a losing record that you're playing.
Yeah.
So I know it's LSU and it's Mississippi State and it's Alabama, but and Ole Miss, but they all have a losing record.
Right.
So you got a chance.
Yeah.
Don't look in the rearview mirror. Look ahead, and you could get things kind of turned around. You know, Auburn won 12 of 15 last year coming down the stretch.
Yeah.
And was the hottest team in SEC. They're going to have a similar run to that to try to make the SEC tournament this year. It's a little different. They dug themselves way too big of a hole. But you know what? You can't worry about what's in the past. You can't fix that.
No.
So.
And you know, like I said, it's just the nature of baseball is it's not a thing. In football, if you're good, you generally are good from start to finish. You know what I mean?
Right.
Baseball has those ups and downs, man, player by player, right? I mean, every player is going to slump at some point.
No doubt.
It was when does the slump happen, right? Does the slump happen at the right time or the wrong time? And it's kind of what Auburn's going through. A little bit of what the Braves are going through right now, but.